Hello students, in this video lecture we are going to study about methods for the preparation of aldehydes and ketones. As there are many number of methods for the preparation of aldehydes and ketones, we are going to study these methods in two parts. In part one, we are going to study about by using the oxidation of alcohol by oxidizing agent and dehydrogenation of alcohol by copper. From hydrocarbons, ozonolysis and hydration of alkyne, these two methods from hydrocarbons, and from acyl chlorides we are going to prepare aldehydes and ketones, aliphatic and aromatic, both type of this carbonyl compound. First we see method for the preparation of aldehydes and ketone by oxidation of alcohol and by using oxidizing agent. Now see here, when we are going to prepare here aldehydes and ketone from alcohols, so primary alcohols, they undergo dehydrogenation reaction, and with the oxidizing agent like CrO3, dilute nitric acid, KMnO4, K2Cr2O7, these are oxidizing agent. And when these primary alcohols reacts with these oxidizing agent, they use aldehydes. But by using these oxidizing agent, when we get aldehydes, the reaction not stop at the first thing. It further shows the oxidation of aldehyde and it gives the product carboxylic acid. Therefore, instead of these oxidizing agent, PCC, that is pyridinium chlorochromate, is used for the conversion of primary alcohol to aldehydes. Means by using that reagent, pyridinium chlorochromate, we get here aldehyde as a stable product. They further not converted into the carboxylic acids. Now see, for the secondary alcohols, on oxidation they form ketones. Means for the primary alcohols, when they undergo the oxidation, they form aldehydes. Secondary, they form ketones. And in case of tertiary alcohols, they are very difficult to oxidize. On oxidation at higher temperature, breaking of carbon-carbon bond takes place and alkenes are formed. But now see here that when we get these products after the oxidation of tertiary alcohols, so what they require, the stronger oxidizing agent, and we get here that product which contain less number of carbon atom than the tertiary alcohols. Therefore, it is difficult for the tertiary alcohols to oxidize. See, the general reaction for the primary alcohol with the PCC, pyridinium chlorochromate, they shows the oxidation reaction by the removal of H2O. Means they shows dehydrogenation reaction and formation of aldehydes. For the secondary alcohols, what we require here, CrO3, with they shows the oxidation reaction by the removal of H2O, and products are ketones. The example for this oxidation reaction, primary alcohol, ethyl alcohol, in presence of PCC, undergo oxidation reaction by the removal of H2O. Means from the ethyl alcohol, removal of H2O takes place, addition of oxygen and formation of ethanol. Means alcohol is converted into the aldehydes in presence of pyridinium chlorochromate. For secondary alcohols, CrO3 is required, and again the similar type of reaction, means H2O dehydration reaction takes place with the formation of acetone. And see what happened for the tertiary alcohols, they not form carbonyl compound as a products. Okay, they what they forms by the removal of H2O, and for the removal of H2O, OH from the tertiary alcohol, OH from the tertiary alcohol, and hydrogen of the CH3 group. Okay, and what they form? H2O with the formation of isobutylene. Means what we can say here, the primary alcohols after the oxidation form aldehydes, secondary alcohols which undergo the oxidation formation of ketone. Similar type of conversions are carried out by using the copper container, and dehydrogenation reaction takes place here. Means by the removal of H2 from alcohol, carbonyl compounds are formed. Okay, means now see the same type of conversion, primary alcohol is converted into the aldehyde, secondary alcohol is converted into the ketone, but in presence of copper container, when you are heated this primary alcohol at 573 Kelvin temperature, by the removal of H2O, formation of the aldehyde takes place. Okay. So these are the reactions in which we are going, we converted here alcohol into aldehydes and ketones. Remember, primary alcohol after oxidation forms ketone, secondary it forms a secondary it form the ketone, and for the tertiary alcohols they form isobutylene. See, so here you have given here examples by using that alcohols and heating with the copper. They show the oxidation reaction. Ethyl alcohol form ethanol. Here the removal of H2 takes place. For the ethyl alcohol when form ethanol. For the secondary alcohol, isopropyl alcohol, when heated in copper container at 573 Kelvin temperature, oxidation takes place and it forms acetone by the removal of H2. Okay, dehydrogenation reaction takes place. And for the tertiary alcohol, it not form carbonyl compound, whereas it forms the isobutylene alkene, and it shows the dehydration reaction by the removal of H2O, it forms the isobutylene. So this is all about the oxidation reaction for the conversion of alcohol to aldehydes and ketones. We are going to prepare your aldehydes and ketone from hydrocarbons, and in the hydrocarbon first we use your alkenes and ozonolysis reaction. Actually, you all studied that method in the 11th standard, ozonolysis of alkene. Means, see here, ethene when reacts with ozone. See in the reaction that one oxygen is get added in between the two carbon atom in the ozonide ring, and remaining two oxygen they form the ozonide ring. So by the addition of O3 into ethene, formation of ozonide ring takes place, and with the ZN and H2O, that ring get rupture here and formation of formaldehyde takes place. Okay, the two molecules of formaldehyde we get here by the removal of zinc oxide. So this is the ozonolysis reaction for the preparation of carbonyl compounds from alkenes. See here one more example, 2-methyl-butene, and when it shows the ozonolysis reaction, we get the two different carbonyl compound. One is propan-2-ON and one is aldehydes. Means we get here one aldehyde and one ketone as a products by using the 2-methyl-butene. So by that this reaction ozonolysis, we get here carbonyl compounds as a product. Next reaction is hydration of alkynes. When alkynes reacts with water in presence of 40% sulfuric acid and 1% mercuric sulfate, they use aldehydes and or ketones. Now ethyne when reacts with water in presence of 40% H2SO4, 1% mercuric sulfate. Now see what happened here. From the ethyne, the triple bond containing in between the two carbon atom, it forms a double bond structure. Okay, means see here, the triple bond is converted to the double bond by the addition of, on one carbon atom, hydrogen is added from H2O and OH group is added on one carbon atom. Means from the H2O, H and OH. So on one carbon atom, H is get added and on the other carbon atom, OH. So we get here the structure CH2 double bond CH-OH. This is vinyl alcohol and it shows a tautomerism. And in the tautomerism, see the one hydrogen of OH group, it goes towards the CH2 group and it forms the structure CH3CH, and that is a C double bond O. Means that ethynes are converted into aldehydes. See, if you are taken here propyne, which contain that carbon-carbon triple bond, and with the carbon atom, it is attached to the one alkyl group, that is CH3 group. So in that case, what happened here that by the addition of this H2O, means the hydration of propyne takes place, it forms very unstable structure and it shows the tautomerism. When it shows the tautomerism, hydrogen of OH group. Okay, hydrogen of OH group is goes towards that CH2 carbon atom and it forms the CH3. And formation of ketone from propyne. So this is a reaction for the preparation of aldehydes or ketone by using the hydration of alkyne. Next type of reactions in which you are going to use here reactant acyl chlorides. And these acyl chloride, by using these acyl chlorides, we are going to prepare here aliphatic aldehydes, aromatic aldehydes, aliphatic ketones or aromatic ketones. When acyl chloride is hydrogenated over catalyst palladium with the barium sulfate, so they give the aldehydes on ketones. And that reaction is called as Rosemont reduction reaction. Now see, for the acyl chlorides and into acyl chlorides we are adding here H2, means addition of hydrogen, and therefore that reaction is called as Rosemont reduction. See, this is a reduction reaction and name Rosemont reduction reaction. This is for the preparation of aldehydes. That reaction is only known as Rossmann reduction. For the preparation of ketone by using acyl chlorides, we are not using this same process. Okay, what you are using here? Dialkyl cadmium means aldehydes and ketone, they show the different reaction with the acyl chlorides. First, we see about for the preparation of aldehydes from acyl chlorides. Okay, and acyl chlorides formula are C double bond OCl. These acyl chlorides, they are reduced to the corresponding aldehydes by using H2. Using a palladium catalyst and with the barium sulfate. So now see that C double bond OCl in the acyl chloride structure. That change is here. C double bond O remain as it is. Only the Cl of acyl chloride is replaced by H. And the Cl, it is removed in the form of HCl. And what we get here, the structure RC double bond OH. Means only from the acyl chloride, Cl is replaced by H. If you are taken R is equal to CH3, the name of that structure is acetyl chloride. So from the acetyl chloride, by the addition of H2 chloride of that acetyl chloride, it is replaced by H and we get the product acetaldehyde. So this is for the preparation of aliphatic aldehydes and what is the name? Rossmann reduction. We can prepare here aromatic type of aldehydes by changing that R of acyl chlorides. If you are taken R is equal to C6H5, phenyl ring with the C double bond OCl, we get the structure benzoyl chloride. And benzoyl chloride in presence of H2 and by using the catalyst hydrogen with the palladium and barium sulfate, formation of benzaldehyde takes place. So this is a reaction, Rossmann reduction. Remember the name Rossmann reduction for the preparation of aliphatic or aromatic type of aldehyde by using acyl chloride. Next is preparation of aliphatic ketone from acyl chlorides. For the aliphatic ketones, that acyl chlorides by using that reaction with the dialkyl cadmium. Means what we require here, dialkyl cadmium with the acyl chloride. But see, the first reaction is for the preparation of dialkyl cadmium. How it is prepared? It is prepared by using Grignard's reagents. Means RMgX with the cadmium chloride. RMgX with the cadmium chloride, formation of dialkyl cadmium, R2CD. That we require for the preparation of acyl chloride. Now see the reaction, general reaction for the preparation of ketone from acyl chloride, RC double bond OCl with the dialkyl cadmium. Now see what happened here, R-CO is remain as it is. Only that Cl from acyl chloride, it is removed with the cadmium chloride. Okay, that Cl and cadmium, it is formation of cadmium chloride one. And that R2, it get added into that acyl group and formation of a ketone takes place. For the preparation of aromatic ketone, only what you have to change here, that R. So if that R is equal to aryl group, they form the aromatic ketone. If R is equal to alkyl group, they form the aliphatic ketone. We see the examples for that reaction. Acyl chloride by the reaction with dialkyl cadmium, that is R2CD, formation of ketones. Ethanyl chloride, CH3COCl, when reacts with the dimethyl cadmium. See here what happened in that reaction, CH3CO and CH3, they are added from the dimethyl cadmium. And Cl of that ethanyl chloride, it removes in the form of cadmium chloride. Similar type of reaction for the preparation of aromatic ketones by using benzoyl chloride with the dimethyl cadmium. And what you get, the product is acetophenone. So this is a reaction for the preparation of aromatic type of ketones. So now see the one more reaction here for the preparation of aromatic ketone from acyl chloride. But what you are using here? Hydrocarbon benzene. Okay, these hydrocarbon benzenes when heated with the acyl chloride, or we can use acetic anhydride. Okay, the same product we get here, that is in presence of anhydrous aluminium chloride, they use the corresponding acyl benzene. Here benzene with the acetyl chloride. Now see, from the benzene, hydrogen is replaced. Okay, one hydrogen is replaced and that hydrogen is goes with the HCl, trimol of HCl, and from the acetyl chloride C double bond OCH3, C double bond OCH3 group, that group is introduced into the benzene and formation of C6H5 C double bond OCH3 acetophenone takes place. So these that method aromatic ketone, this is used for only the preparation of aromatic ketone. By using that, we are not get here aliphatic ketones. Okay, so this is a method by using acyl chloride and hydrocarbon. Now see here what we completed here, that some methods for the preparation of aldehydes and ketone by the oxidation of alcohol, in which you are studied two methods by using oxidizing agent, as well as we have completed this method by using the copper. Okay, the dehydrogenation of alcohol by using copper. From hydrocarbon, we completed ozonolysis reaction, ozonolysis of alkene and hydration of alkyne to get the products, that carbonyl compound. And from acyl chlorides, we prepare here aliphatic and aromatic type of ketones. So here we completed about the methods for the preparation of aldehydes and ketones. Thank you.